Hello everybody, today I am going to start a new chapter, DC choppers. DC chopper converts fixed DC input voltage to variable DC output voltage. Various types of DC choppers are available for various applications. Sometimes within a circuit, various levels of output voltage are required. Those levels can be obtained from a single source using this kind of choppers. So, DC choppers, it converts fixed DC to variable DC. It is DC equivalent to an AC transformer with a continuously variable turns ratio. As in case of transformer, we know that output voltage can be increased or decreased by changing the turns ratio of the transformer. Here, similar thing is available, but in case of DC. Here, turns ratio we are not changing. Here, we will change the duty cycle of the switches. This kind of choppers are used in traction motor control, trolley cars, marine hoists, regenerative braking of DC motors, DC voltage regulators and many other applications. Objective of this chapter is to learn the switching technique for different types of DC to DC converters, then to study the working principle of DC converters, to understand the performance parameters of DC converters like average output voltage, RMS output voltage, etc. To learn the techniques for the analysis and design of DC converters. That means to design the inductor, capacitor, switch selection in a DC to DC converter. And to study continuous and discontinuous modes of operations. Continuous conduction mode means continuously we will get current across the load. And discontinuous means for some duration of time current is zero. Let's start with a simple DC choppers. Now the DC chopper can convert our fixed DC voltage to output voltage more than the input voltage or less than the input voltage. Here in this case, I am considering a simple step down chopper. Here in the circuit you can see DC input voltage is there. A MOSFET is connected, which we will use as a switch to allow current through the load resistance R. Now you can see when the switch is on, then voltage across the resistance is equal to DC input voltage. 100 volt DC input is given here, so output voltage equal to 100 volt. Now when the switch is off, then output voltage is zero as no current is flowing through the circuit. Current is zero, so voltage is zero. So average output voltage across the load is less than the input voltage. That you can see in this waveform. The average output voltage, it is less than the DC input voltage. That's why the name is a step down converter. Let's analyze this DC to DC step down converter. T is equal to on period plus off period is known as complete time period of the switching pulses. Here in DC choppers, generally T is kept constant. That means frequency is constant. And on period or off period is varied to vary the output voltage. V is equal to DC input voltage and D is a very important term known as duty cycle, and it is defined as ratio of on time divided by total time period. V out instantaneous is your instantaneous output voltage at any instant T. So the average voltage across the load can be written as V0 is equal to 1 by complete time period, that is t, integration 0 to on period t1, and the instantaneous output voltage dt. So you will get 1 by t v t1, and t1 by t is equal to duty cycle. So average output voltage equal to v into d. Now this output voltage can be varied based on the value of this d, and d can be between 0 to 1 or 0% to 100%. If the duty cycle is 0, it indicates that switch is completely off, and if d is equal to 100%, that means switch is completely on. So these two states are generally not used in DC chopper. Then RMS output voltage equal to square root of 1 by complete time period 0 to on time V out instantaneous square dt, and you will get RMS output voltage equal to V into root d. Now one thing here I want to say, that the output voltage is in terms of pulses. These are not usable form. You cannot use these pulses for different applications. So smooth DC output voltage is required. To get a smooth DC output voltage, these pulses are to be filtered out using inductor and capacitor. Let's see that. Here a inductor and capacitor is connected across the load resistance to filter the pulsating output voltage. A diode D is connected to freewheel the energy stored across the inductor. When the switch is on, current will flow through DC input, switch, inductor to capacitor as well as to resistance. When the switch is off, then inductor will change its polarity and it will freewheel through inductance, resistance and diode. At the same time, capacitor will also discharge through the load resistance. So load resistance continuously getting current, so output voltage will be there. This is the reason that continuous output voltage by using this L and C second order filter you will get across the load. Switching frequency of MOSFET is 10 kHz and the inductance 30 micro Henry, capacitance 30 microfarad. DC input voltage is taken as 30 volt and the output voltage is obtained 15 volt at 50% duty cycle, and the resistance is taken as 5 ohm. So you can see in the waveform, input voltage is 30 volt, output voltage is exactly 15 volt. So the pulsating output voltage is now filtered and a smooth output voltage is obtained, and this output voltage is in usable form, can be used for various applications. So today, just basic of DC to DC converter we have discussed, and we have seen that a reduced output voltage can be obtained by reducing the duty cycle. So the output voltage is always less than the input voltage, that's why the name of this converter is DC to DC step down converter. Sometimes it is known as buck converter. And then the pulsating output voltage have been filtered using a second order LC filter to obtain a smooth DC output voltage in usable form. Then we have found out the average and RMS value of the pulsating output voltage. In coming classes, we will see detailed analysis of this converter. Thank you.